again, and today we've got an edition of special looks, TikTok girls looks. We're going to be doing three types of aesthetics. It's gonna be soft girl, it's gonna be e-girl, and a visco girl. And this video is in collaboration with Style Stunner, and she will be helping me styling the outfits. So you guys stay tuned and let's get into it. So let's start with the soft girl look. Soft girl look is a social media type of look for young girls, and it's very popular aesthetics. It includes soft makeup with blush pink eyes, like I tried just now. It is based on deliberately cute and feminine look. Oversized fluffy sweaters are characteristics, fluffy jumpers, pleated skirts, anything pink or yellow. So for example, like this bag, it's kind of 90s style. It's not very good quality, but it is typical soft girl look, and it's pastel, it's purple. So this is what the soft girl would go for. And the next thing is anything floral. So I've got puffy sleeves, cute girly floral organza blouse, and this is actually jacket, and it's from ASOS again. So this will be my go-to look. She likes also denim pants, mostly mom style denim pants, and cute little heels or cute trainers. So that's the go-to look. So as I said, for soft girl, you will need a really pink lipstick and also a lot of blush. So I'll put my lipstick on. And this one is from Hermes, so this is cute little bracelet. It's nice and pastel pink, so this will go perfectly with my soft girl look. And I've got a shoe, so these shoes, so this could be also cute little sort of Japanese style, a soft girl look. And they are the Harakuju Lovers. I've got a protective sole layer to protect the damage of beautiful back of these shoes. And also you can try any pastel bags, for example this one. These are non-designer bags. Both of the handbags I'm showing you are from ASOS, so this would be the soft girl look. But also you can use it for visco girl, actually any of these aesthetics. They like 90s style bags, so it's not going to be any totes. Also you can use rucksacks. This is what soft girl likes. So let's get changed and let's take some shots. So this is my first aesthetic, floral organza blouse, and it has a puffy sleeves and I have two choices of two different bags. So it can be either the pastel green or the purple. So both of them looks good because it's a floral print. So let's go and get some stylish photos. Well, everyone, this is my first outfit. I have combined the organza blouse just with a long sleeve top, and I wore hijab quite loose for the soft girl look. I always wear it quite loose. It looks more 70s, and I've got my bracelet on and my 90s bag, and you can see the puffy sleeves. So you could also wear it with a skirt, and for more sporty look with trainers. So I'm trying some unconventional photos. So you see, I'm using mirror, and this photo shoot should look good. Thank you. Okay, so this is the last shot. So you can see this is a satin shoulder bag, baguette bag, and I'm wearing this puffy sleeves jacket and the jeans. So let me know down below what you think about this outfit. I wore jersey hijab just to try it on with this. Next aesthetic is Visco Girl. Visco Girl is preppy, beachy, laid back. She always likes nature and animals, and sometimes she is preppy. She wears scrunchies, and the characteristic sound is x-x-x-x-x. Everybody knows it. Visco girls like to wear bands. She likes to wear necklaces with the shell on, and she also likes to wear backpacks from the brands like Pura. Some people make fun of Visco girls. They mark them as a basic sort of version of young Karen, which we see going around on internet. And they are sometimes marked as eco-friendly pixie warriors. However, this is actually good because we're trying to save our planet, so we shouldn't mock the Visco girls. And actually, aesthetic is very comfortable. And if you want to see it in the modest edition, instead of shorts, you can use tracksuit bottoms. Visco girls always uses facial spray, and her skin is dewy, and she uses flasks, and they are always full of water, and everything has to be eco-friendly, no plastic. And yes, so there is lots of parodies going around on TikTok about Visco girls. One of them is that Visco girl cannot go without 5 breaths without saying "and I oop." And I oop. We are hijabi, so we can use scrunchies under the hijab to give us volume. And if Visco girl was hijabi, she would wear sliders, she would wear tracksuit bottoms, baggy oversized t-shirts with jumpers. Also, she would wear very oversized hoodies, and she would wear hijab quite loose. Of Visco girl. I've got my scrunchie, handbag, vans with basic socks, and I want to look as basic as possible. I'm not going to bother with doing my scarf. I'm just very laid back, and I forgot my flask, but it's in my Range Rover. And I love sky and green because I love nature. So, what do you guys think? Culture which emerged in early 2010 exclusively on social media was e-girl or e-boy aesthetic. This was popularized by the video app TikTok, as we all know. So the inspiration from this subculture is mostly from the skater fashion, from the K-pop, and from grunge and rave culture. Also, it takes inspiration from hip-hop and goth. The girls and boys who like this fashion, they also prefer alternative style choices such as thrifted fashion, and they wear hairs pink and green. Both boys and girls wear particularly heavy makeup, pink eyeshadow, pink lips, heavy blush on the cheeks, and the characteristics are the nails and the chains around the waist, and also heavy rings. They also draw small freckles and small shapes under the eyes to imitate the anime and Lolita fashion. The girls which wear makeup, it's the style of the makeup is mixed between Harakuju, Emo and Igari makeup. And lots of artists are influenced by this subculture, particularly Billie Eilish and Lil Peep. So I'm wearing the characteristics of this culture. You can see the chain. I cannot have a pink hair. I might put a pink hijab instead of black hijab, not to look too much like a goth. I'm wearing this t-shirt which has a pink animation on the back, and of course I'm wearing the belt with the chains and characteristic stripy t-shirt. The girls sometimes wear short pleated skirt, but I opted for stripy 60s flat trousers, and I draw a small shapes under my eyes, and I put heavy pink lip and heavy pink eye. So let me know what you guys think. So this is my outfit. In the end, I opted for the pink hijab. I'm wearing pink scarf, and I've got this hat on because they do wear hats. So what do you guys think about this aesthetic? Comment down below. So you guys, hope you enjoyed my video on different styles and different type of online subculture. So comment below which one did you like the most, and if you like the modest edition of these subcultures, and comment below which of these styles is your favorite. For me, I think the first one is the most wearable one, and Visco girl is a little bit too basic for me. I don't like too basic things. So this was all from me from today, and I will check out and I will see you on the next one, and let me know down below what would you like to see, even if it's a medical segment or anything aesthetic wise.